today, me and my group members would like to talk about Joseph John Thompson. Hope you guys will enjoy watching our video. Joseph John Thompson, or better known as J.J. Thompson, was born in Quitham Hill on the outskirts of Manchester on December 18, 1856. His father, Joseph James Thompson, ran an antique bookshop founded by a great-grandfather. He had a brother named Frederick Vernon Thompson, who was 2 years younger than him. He is a British physician, noted as an inventor of electrons that are part of an atom. He also received a physical Nobel for his discovery. Early education was in small private schools, where he demonstrated outstanding talent and interest in science. In 1870, he was admitted to Owens College in Manchester. He moved on to Trinity College, Cambridge in 1876. In 1880, he obtained his Bachelor of Arts degree in Mathematics. He applied for and became a Fellow of Trinity College in 1881. Thompson received his Master of Arts degree with Adams Prize in 1883. Thompson was also a speaker in 1883 and became a professor in 1881. Thompson married Rose Elizabeth Paget in January 1890 and was given 2 sons, George Paget Thompson and Joan Paget Thompson. Thompson was also an experimental physics professor at the Cavendish Laboratory, Cambridge, where he replaced John Strutt, 3rd Baron Raleigh, from 1884 to 1918, and became honorary physicist at Cambridge and Royal Institution, London. Now, let's take a look on Joseph John Thompson's researches.
In 1894, Thompson began studying cathode rays, which are glowing beams of light that follow an electrical discharge in a high vacuum tube. It was a popular research topic among physicists at the time, because the nature of cathode rays was unclear. Thompson devised better equipment and methods than had been used before. By using better equipment and method, he able to produce a very narrow beam of cathode rays. To produce this narrow beam, he used a set of plates to set up an electric field. By setting up an electric field, he was hoping to deflect this particular beam either up or down, depending on the polarity of this electric field. So, here at this plate, J.J. Thompson applied a voltage which user was able to regulate and ensure that these plates were close enough so that the electric field was strong enough to deflect this negatively charged particle. And of course, this negatively charged particle is experiencing a force, in this case, in the upward direction. He had done the experiment and observed what happened. He continued his research by calculating the velocity of the cathode ray. Now, he knew that the force due to the magnetic field was equal to QVB, and the force due to the electric field, which he had already established, simply equal to EQ. Because the force are equal, he can cancel out both value of the charge. V is the velocity equal to electric field strength divided by the magnetic field strength. He already knew the magnetic and electric field. Now, he only need to find the velocity of the cathode ray, which he got approximately 1 times 10 to the power of 7 meter per second. That's pretty good. But can you see what it is? The most important thing he managed to calculate, the velocity that he got is not the speed of light, as Maxwell had confirmed that the speed of light or the speed of electromagnetic radiation is a constant value, namely 3 times 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. So, from this experiment, he found new discoveries. Whatever the cathode rays were, they are not a form of electromagnetic radiation. Then, he removed the electric field and measures the amount of deflection in a different trooper. He was able to measure the amount of turning within a magnetic field. He also able to work the charge to mass ratio Q over M equal to V over BR of this unknown cathode ray particle. It was already known that at that time that hydrogen atom, known as the smallest atom. After calculate, he found that the mass of cathode ray is 1,800 times smaller than the mass of the hydrogen atom. So, he concluded that he found a new particle, which 1,800 times smaller than proton, and the particle is negatively charged and same size as hydrogen ion. Then the new particle he named based on the Greek word for amber, which is electrum, and hence we have the electron.
In 1906, Joseph John Thomson was awarded the Nobel Prize for Physics after his discovery of the electron in 1897. The Nobel Prize is what could be called one of the most prestigious awards in the world. It is only given to the greatest minds, hardest working, and most dedicated men or women. The Nobel Prize truly helped J.J. Thomson make his mark on history.
Thomson was awarded the Royal Medal in 1894. This award is given each year by the Royal Society to the two most important developments in natural knowledge. It is given this to his exceptional studies in mathematics and in physics, in particular to his studies in the electrical theory. And lastly, the Hughes Medal was awarded to J.J. Thomson in 1902. It is given by the Royal Society of London for original discoveries. Peace.